And what will you keep for yourself, my lord?
My hopes, replied Alexander.
I want to tell you a couple stories about Alexander the Great here, continuing about him and his leadership style and how he was able to command such incredible devotion and fidelity from his men for years and years under the most arduous possible conditions. So here's the first story. Before Alexander set out from Macedonia to advance against the Persian Empire, now this was after he had conquered Greece and he had conquered the wild tribes to the north of Macedonia, the Illyrians and Triballians and others. He was maybe 22 years old. He called the whole army together at a place called Dium on the Magnesian coast. It was a great festival where they had races and contests and all kinds of horse exercises and stuff like that. So he called all the army together and he began giving away everything that he owned. The properties of the crown, which were great country estates to his generals and farms and pasture lands to his colonels and his officers. He gave away mining concessions. He gave away fishing rights. He gave away woodlands, logging concessions to his sergeants and to his senior sergeants. And every, right down to the soldier, the common soldier, he gave away a little farm, a little cottage, a little pasture land. And by the end of this extraordinary evening, his men were like begging him to stop, please stop, stop. And one of his friends said to him, "And what will you keep for yourself, my lord?" And Alexander replied, "My hopes." Alexander was impressing upon his men that in the battles to come, when he was going to ask them to, put their lives on the line and their limbs and everything, that they would know that he wasn't going to be standing by to take all the fruits of their effort, that that meant nothing to him, that he was only after glory and something that would live forever. So that's one story. Another story is that the army, Alexander's army, was crossing a mountain range in winter under hellish frozen conditions, going through the snow. The sun had set, it was dark, men were freezing and dropping out on the side, and they were trying to get to the advanced camps where the first parties had been able to build fires and get some food and broth going. And this one older soldier, a veteran soldier, was struggling particularly through the snow, through the cold, through all the stuff. Finally, he staggered in to a little camp by a fire, and he was so exhausted and so out of it that he didn't know where he was or where anything was. And he flopped down next to the fire in a seat, and they gave him some broth, they warmed him up, they put the fleece over his shoulders or something. And after a few minutes, he kind of came to himself and he realized where he was, and he looked, and sitting next to him was Alexander. And he realized, oh my God, he'd taken the king's seat. And he kind of leapt up in a state of consternation, and he apologized profusely, to Alexander. And Alexander stopped him. He said, "This seat is yours, my brother, for you are Alexander, even more than I myself." So again, the great aspect of Alexander's leadership there was that he just identified so completely with his men and allowed them to identify with him. So what we're talking about here really, again, is the warrior archetype and the king archetype and how the two of them kind of fuse in Alexander. The deeper issue here is it's very clear that Alexander was a king, a true king, to his men, to his own army, to his fellow Macedonians. But the bigger question is, was he a king to the peoples that he had conquered? Was he a king to the people of Babylon, to the people of Egypt, to the people of Armenia, to the people of all of the lands that he had brought under his rule? And now we're getting into certain moral issues, and we're talking about the limitations of the warrior archetype. And in our next episode, we're going to talk about a confrontation that Alexander had with a great king in India named Porus, P-O-R-U-S. And we come up against the difference between the warrior archetype and the king archetype.